In the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, one God, Amen. Today is the Vespers of the fourth Sunday of the month of Tut. And in this week, in the Vespers, tomorrow in the morning, and tomorrow in Matins and in the liturgy, there are three stories of three righteous women whom each one of them had different mindset and different need and different problem, and the three are having one thing in common. I will not tell you what is this thing, but you need to guess and to know what is this thing in common between the three ladies. The first lady is the lady that had, she was bleeding for 12 years and came from behind and touched the hem of his garment. Do you know what is the hem of the garment? What is the hem of the garment? This can be the hem of a garment. The very little tiny, and you will find in the Jewish tradition, in their cloth there is something like this sadra, but it has the same. So it is long from in front and also from the back, the same length. So as if it is exactly one identical cloth, the same from the back is the same length. It is not that short like the sadra that the clergy or the abuna is putting on. And it end, and it end with the hem or a small string that is attached to the clothes of the Lord. And she said in her heart, if I only may touch his garment, I shall be made well. And she touched the hem of his garment, and she was healed. This is the first lady. The second lady of tomorrow morning, a woman from Canaan came from the region and cried out to him, saying, have mercy on me, O Lord, son of David. My daughter is severely demon-possessed, and she is praying and requesting that the Lord will heal her daughter. And the Lord did heal her daughter afterwards. And the gospel is speaking about the sinful woman in the city that went and broke an alabaster flask of oil on the feet of the Lord and wiped his feet with his hair, her hair. The lady of today, she is having sickness, physical sickness. Tomorrow morning, her son, her daughter is sick. Third is the lady of in the gospel of tomorrow. She was living a sinful life and she returned back to God. The Lord told the three ladies, your faith made you well today. Tomorrow morning, O woman, great is your faith. It is, let it be according to your desire. Unheard of in the scripture that God is telling someone, whatever you ask for, according to your desire. And the third lady in the gospel of the liturgy, your faith have saved you, go in peace. What is the three, or the one common thing that is there in the three ladies? Any other ideas? What is the common thing in the three ladies? They're all girls. Being ladies, they are girls by default. Their faith. They all have problems. And they all treated or dealt with the problem through their faith. And it is an amazing thing. Because when we are stuck, when we are in towards the end of our rope, when there is no hope, when there is no way out, when things is going really out of control, and we have no control over things. Sometimes people get depressed, sometimes people get down, sometimes people get hopeless, sometimes people say, well, then God does not exist. Whatever is the response of the people. But those three ladies, the three of them had faith. And the Lord highlighted or zoomed in or had a spotlight on their faith. Your faith made you well. You were healed because of your faith. A woman Great is your faith, let it be according to your desire. And he healed her daughter. Your faith have saved you, go in peace. And this is the sinful woman. So, dealing with problems, the three ladies came to the Lord, and the three ladies had faith, and the three ladies, their issues were fixed or were solved, regardless of the time of the problem, but the three had an answer for the prayers. And sometimes this is why our prayers are not answered, that we don't trust in God, and we don't have faith. And it said in the scripture, without faith we cannot. Without faith we cannot please God. بدون إيمان لا يمكن إرضاء. You cannot please God without having faith. You cannot please Him. And it is a key, because those who are in the names of the saints that we remember in the commemoration of the saints, that they have been perfected in. They have been perfected in their faith. Remember, O Lord, those few who went to the Hebrew book. The evangelists, the martyrs, the confessors, and all the spirits of the righteous perfected in their faith, or perfected in faith. And it is tough to have a strong faith around you when people are not having that strong faith. And it is tough when you are going through tough times in your life and you lose hope and you lose faith and you start doubting if God is there or God is backing you up or God is not there for you. There is a story of a man who was from a Jewish origin. This story happened in Torrance, here in California. A very devout, very brilliant young man. He's an accountant, and he was doing a great job in his career. He was managing the business of a very, very wealthy man, and this man passed away, and his wife, very young lady, took his inheritance. And the wife of the old man who passed away started asking this young man for to compromise on the accounting system and to do inappropriate things, and he told her no. And she made up an accusation against him, and he was sent to prison, and he stayed in prison for a while. And when there was a pastor who was going to serve in the prison, he had only the New Testament, so he met this Jewish guy from Torrance, and he told him, "You have the Old Testament," because he doesn't believe in the New Testament. He told him, "I'm so sorry, I don't have the Old Testament, but I have the New Testament. If it can help, I will give it to you." So he said, "Okay, I will take the New Testament." And he took the New Testament, and he go through the reading of the New Testament, and in he stopped at the story of the disciples being tormented in the boat where the water is coming in and they are perishing. And he found the gospel reading is Jesus walking on the water. And it just surprised him, and he was losing faith. He said, "I have been righteous, I have been not doing any sin, I have been obeying the commandments of God, and why God is permitting me to go all the way and to be in prison unjustly and to face this judgment." And when he was reading in the scripture, he said, "If you are really God," he's asking Christ, "if you are really God that walked on the water in this gospel, then you will be able to deliver me from this situation. It is not a big deal for you." And a few days after, he received a message that they needed him for they opened another investigation, because the owner of that company was doing a lot of bad stuff, So it was revealed, and they expected that she, what she claimed or accused this righteous accountant, was wrong. So they opened the investigation, and he was released, and he didn't have anything in his record. He had a friend who was a Coptic, and he connected him to the Coptic Church in Torrance. And I'm just telling you that when we trust in God, and when we have faith, because he trusted in God, but he had doubt, and he told him, if you are really truly the true God, then intervene and make an action. So how we can increase our faith? How we can increase our faith? Faith is linked to two things. The more we pray, the more we have faith. The less we pray, the less we have faith. Faith is linked to prayer. Faith is linked to prayer. And in order to measure, you know, when you have the light in your car, it's telling you the oil is less, or it's yellow blinking, and you need to check the level of the oil. So checking the level of the faith is checking the level of the fear. At the A, احنا بنخاف. How much we are afraid or scared or have fear in our heart. The more we have fear, the less we have faith. The less we have fear, the more we have faith. So measuring the faith, the easiest way is to measure it by the level of fear. So how to increase the faith? Number one, the disciples ask God, increase our faith. This is a Bible verse in the Gospel of St. Mark. They told him, increase our faith, because our faith, we are struggling in this. We need to trust you more. We need to hold on you more. So the first thing to increase our faith is requesting it. And the prayer is a big venue, or is a big. The more we pray, the more we have faith. The less we pray, the less we have faith. This is a rule. Second thing that I will end with this is, the more we humble ourselves, the more we are meek, the more we are humble, the more we trust in God more. The more we are humble, the more we trust in God more. The more we are prideful, the more we trust in ourselves and don't trust in God. And here, when things is going out of control, may God give me and give each one of us that we will take those three righteous ladies, whom God has praised their faith in different situations in the Bible. Those are the readings of today, tomorrow's matin, and tomorrow's liturgy, and count on our faith, that is the bridge that carries us on top of any problem or any struggles or any tough situations. And this is the Bible verse that really gives a lot of comfort when you see a lot of things wrong happening around us. And this is the victory that we have over the world. Our faith. هذه الغلبة التي لنا على العالم إيمانا. May God give us that we will continue with more prayers to increase our faith and to humble ourselves, because the more we humble ourselves, the more we trust Him. And the more we trust Him, this is simply the definition of faith, is the glory forever and ever.